On Boxing Day, hundreds of horse racing patrons turned out to Ellis Thomas Downs in Seacoast Bay to see Violet Letty Hodges' horse, Really Uptown, dominate the feature event from the gate to the finish, way ahead of St. Croix champion horse Slevin. The race was highly anticipated by horse race fans as expectations ran high following the November 25th matchup in St. Croix when Really Uptown beat Slevin to emerge the winner in a record time. Paul on the Ball has his report.
The feature race of the day at the Ellis Thomas Downs racetrack in Seacoast Bay saw Really Uptown prove that he is truly the sprint demon of the Virgin Islands, defeating Bobo Bates' Wonder Horse Slevin in a time of 1:43 flat over the mile, with Good Prospecting coming in third place.
I told you before you interviewed me for the race, I told you I'm going to cross the finish line first. I know what the kind of horse I have, and I know he was ready. And anybody else who was coming to challenge him was going to get very disappointed because I was crossing the finish line first. And impressively too.
A 7 and a mile, was any different for you for that race?
No. I spoke to the trainer. He told me, no, a mile, let's go. It's only a little a furlong or whatever it is. But yeah. He told me let's go first and we went.
I'm coming Triple Crown.
Triple Crown, we won't go on the Triple Crown. I think we'll go in the Sprint Classics. Because what I plan to do is just beat all the sprinters and then maybe I'll decide to come back up and deal with the rest.
Do you think Slevin want any part of Uptown?
No, I think he learned his lesson.
And after all the hype, I caught up with a solemn Bobo Bates, the owner of Slevin.
What did your estimation happen?
Well, I mean, we tried to go from the gate with Really Uptown and we stayed alongside him. But I guess when we coming home, Really Uptown hit him, had another gear and he went.
Is it a matter of a misinterpretation from your jockey, or is it a matter of Really Uptown just being the better horse?
Well, right now he's the better horse. I mean, Slevin have been running some races. He run a couple hard races from Thanksgiving, the race before. Now we come and run Christmas. He run a couple good races all year and probably need a little rest right now.
And in other races, the open race of the day, a 6-furlong Class C race with a purse of $3,000 added, saw local horse Cholito win in a time of 1:22 4/5 with Man from the Hill in second place. In race 2, debutant Torrento got the win over the 7-furlong Class C and D horses in a time of 1:32 4/5. Race 3 for Mares and Fillies saw St. Thomas's Good Evening Officer win the 7-furlong race in a time of 1:29 3/5. And in race four, St. Thomas continued their dominance, winning the mile race with Kundan to defeat the popular Gafoleon, taking a purse of $4,500. For JTV Sports, I am Paul on the Ball, and who be a great sport.